So now let's reboot to see what's happened to our system. Reboot. Look, the spinner and everything is dark. So look, everything is dark. Go, everything is dark. And there's the spinner, small spinner, very fast, you know, 3 seconds, 5 seconds, and we are in the system. We are direct in the system. Now we welcome to the system. Okay? Now let us improve the user interface. So see this transparency top bar, we don't like it. And here, the workspace, also we don't like it. After that, I will teach you how to solve this guy. And also the icon is not nicer. Is not look nicer. For example, when I make the maximize, so here the spinner, the top bar become solid brown. When I make like this, the top bar become transparent. I don't like this change, and I don't like the transparent. I want to control this. I want to control everything in my operating system, because here I am in Linux, not in Windows, okay? Not in Mac also. So to do this, first, before we started to customize the user interface, let's customize the setting. So we'll go to the setting. Let's customize the setting. So in the background, let's choose our preferences. We go to document, it's document and GNOME picture 2020. Control A, Control C, go to picture, Control V. Now close this. Now go to the background and picture. Which was the mountain one? Where's one with the mountain? One. Go to the look screen color and we make it dark. Okay, so now we didn't finish yet. Minimize it, tweak, and in the tweak we go to here. From zoom we change it to stretched, and it is stretched. We close this. Now let's continue the setting. Notification, these two guys make it off. Search, off. Sorry, the up one, off. Universal, cursor. English, I hate the English, guys. I hate the English language. Too many exception for every rule. The exceptions is more than the rules. Okay. Select the medium. Privacy, disable. Leave the history and disable the look screen. Sound, disable this guy. You hear it? Disable. So go to sound effect and disable this. Details, date, make it AM PM and change it from United States to your location. My location is Rome, Italy. Okay, close this and close this. We done. Here we done. So now let's remove this guy. To remove this guy, we log out from Ubuntu and we log into GNOME, and from GNOME we go to tweak, and from tweak we go to workspace and we change the workspace from the default to static to one. Okay, now we will do it. So now I will log out from Ubuntu. Log out.
log out. Now I press space, I press setting, I press ignore on XOR, and I press my password, I press enter, then now I am in the GNU. Okay, in the GNU, I press space, I press tweak, I press enter, I go workspace, in workspace I choose static workspace, and this one. Now I go to setting, my account, log out. Now I press setting, I go to Ubuntu, I press my password again. Now I enter to Ubuntu. When I press, look, the workspace here is removed.
So now let's customize the shortcut key. Setting, keyboard, press keyboard. Now the terminal here is exist, so make it Alt T, terminal, Super D to show all desktop, Super Z to show all your application, and Control Q to close Windows, and modify these codes for another shortcut key for reboot. R systemctl space reboot, Control Alt R. For the shutdown, S systemctl space power off, Control Alt S. Okay, now we finish. So Alt T, terminal, close the terminal, Super D, show the desktop, and Super Z, show all your application. And now we are done with that. So Control Q to close this window. So now we customize our hotkey or shortcut key. Okay, now we want to change this ugly icon. So we go to File. Before, let's also improve this interface. So here I want to make this tray or what. I want to, for example, to copy my folder, the link of my folder. For example, I am here, I want to copy. Here I cannot copy it. So what we have to do, we have to enable. So documents. Another thing, I want to create a new document. Here there is no option for a new document. So I will show you the code that I use for that. So solve. And these two codes to create a new document and to make a tray for the location entry. Okay, open the terminal, paste this code, close the terminal, close the terminal, close, open the file again. And here we are. So here we can copy the path of our folders. Okay, here when you press right click, here there you can create a new document. So now we're done with that. Now let's install the beautiful icon. So write icon, Parpios, and copy this. First we add the Parpios to the repo. So before that, let us also customize the shortcut key in the terminal. So here, let's call it, rename it Ubuntu. Ubuntu. Press enter, the shortcut key for the terminal. So the command, when you use a bash command, you need a shortcut key. So here, a new tab, Control T. Sorry, new tab, Control T. New window, Control N. And close the tab, Control W. close window, Control Q, copy, Control C, paste, Control V, select all, Control A, full screen, Control Shift F, zoom in, Control minus, zoom in, Control equal, which is Control plus, but better to make it to use two hands, two fingers. Control equal, zoom in, and find, Control F, and we close it. We close it. Let's go again to make something very nicer to the Ubuntu here. Color, use transparency, and select transparency. Okay, because transparency is bullshit. So now let's check our shortcut key. So Control T, open new window. Control W, close the window. So play hider, blah 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 blah. So I want to copy this. Okay, to copy this, highlight it, Control C, copy it, Control V, paste it, for example. Okay, now Control plus, maximize, Control minus, minimize. You see, Control O, equal. Okay, Control T, Control W, and that's all. Control Alt T, this is the terminal. So we optimize the terminal. So now let us install the purpose. So Control C, Control V, enter, password, enter. So now we add it to the repository. Yes, enter. Again, update, Control V, update, and install, Control C, Control V, and we install the theme, the theming. Close this. Now close this. Now the theming is installed. Look, now let's change, the icon is installed, not the theme. So tweak, go to the icon, change it to papyrus. This is, okay, papyrus. Look, now we have the nice icon, very, very nice icon. This is very, very nice icon. Now let's tweak the Ubuntu. So go to Chrome. Okay, look how many layers, this layers and this layers and this layers. So let us improve the layers here. Use system title bar, no, uncheck. So now the layers is be nicer. Let me sign into my account because I installed the GNOME extension in my bookmarks. So wait. Okay. So let's go to the GNOME. Let's see if it is installed in our machine. Okay, not installed. So we have to install it here. We go to the project. You go to Debian or Ubuntu. Debian. This Debian. Let's go to Ubuntu because now we are in war with Debian. Let's go. But they are the same command. So Control C, highlight it, Control C, open the terminal, Alt T, Control V, press Enter, password, and that's all. Now close this, refresh. Why? extension is still not installed. Let's see what's happened. Control C, open. Okay, let's close it, close. Again, Chrome. Let's go to the, and installed. Okay, now we have installed. There is no error message. And these the extension. So let's remove all the extension that come with the first. Let's remove all the extension that come in Ubuntu by default. So as we did with Debian, as we did with Fedora, we do the same strategy with Ubuntu. So we say extend, and here I have the these two commands. We highlight them. Control C, open the terminal. Control V, and to be wrong because the Control V, enter, and now after the reboot, this default extension will be go away. Okay, so now let's show our bookmarks, and this is the GNOME extension, control, and one click. So it will be open all at once. And let's see what extension we need. What extension we need. So here we don't need it. Here the Godot, this is my project. I do the project in Linux for two-dimension gaming to create a games and to modify the games. Okay, we don't need it now. We close this. This we don't need it. This what? We don't need it. Yes, this. So this is the top bar. Press enter, press it, enter, okay. So now let's check, cancel. No, not this guy. Okay. So now let's customize. Let's customize this guy. So go to the tweak. Go to extensions. Open extensions, dash to panel, click setting icon, make it top. So now we are top. Now it is top. Now style, make it 32. Okay, here on, here on, okay, and here make it 100. There is still some something wrong with this guy. I don't know what is wrong with this guy. Maybe if he, why this happened? Not supposed to be like that. So let me refresh to see if there's. So let's log out and log in and see if this problem. So now it's work. So let's go to the Chrome, Control T. So now this guy is working. So let's go down. Let's go to tweak to customize it. Extension. So look, the default distinction is deleted. Now we are in the dash to panel extension. So style. So it says this black. Let's continue behavior off disable off. Action, do nothing. And close this. look nicer. U launcher, after that we, let's install it now. Now let's go to the PPA launcher. Sorry. Let's install it in the traditional way. So without update, we add the repo. This. So the art install the launcher. Control it. Sudo apt distro upgrade. Okay, so now the launcher, U launcher. Let's modify the launcher, change at login, add Vita extension. We remove this. Okay. Now the launcher is working. There is another so let's go. Now I have noticed they change this guy. But why they change it, I don't know. So let's go down. Let's open file, for example. Same thing. It was not like that. So let's go to tweak. Let's go to extension. Close it. Open it. So here, maybe here there is something. Okay, style, what we did in the style. If you close this, yeah. Behavior, action, do nothing, tool. No. So there's some bugs. There's some bugs here. There is a bug. So when you maximize the window, it changed the behavior. Look, here now all black. When you maximize, they change the behavior. Yeah. This is the bad side of Ubuntu. They change the behavior. So go close this. Let's continue. Let us continue. This time shift, after that we teach, we make a special video for the time shift. We install this, close this, close this, close this, install this. Try account, install it. work. Okay, it is work. But the OBS is not showing. Anyway, let's continue. No. Install this. Remove. Control, no. Remove accessibility, yes, remove this guy, press enter, and it's removed. Hide activity, no. No. Hot corner, we don't have hot corner. No. 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 Yes. And CPU, no. Let's try this. Let's see if this work or no. It's work here. Strange. Here's work, but in Debian and Fedora is not working. So let's close it. Terminal, no. Close this. So let's customize this guy. Right, I close this. So now let's write tweak to customize the dock bar. This dash to dock, open it, off, check this, launcher, check this, uncheck this, behavior. Minimize, appearance, on, dot, and the color of the dot, on, blue, close, default, change it to fix, make it 100%, on. And on, change it to black. Close it. Now we're done. But let's see file. I don't know why this happened. Look, it's not the human machine interaction is not. My eyes as a human is not good interaction with this fucking top bar, because here is dark and here there is another color, and when you make it down, it's changed. Look, it is changed. So let's make the reboot again and let's see what happened. So now I solved the problem of the top panel. Look, now minimize, still black, maximize black. You see? So how to solve it? Go to the dash to panel, go to style, and make this on, and make it 100, 100. Okay? 100, 100. So if you make this on, no, don't play with this, only this. On, 100, 100, on, 100, 100, this off. And the rest, as it is, leave it, okay? So now we finish from the user interface. Now let's do this again. Go to tweak, and you go to desktop, disable this and disable this to make it clean, focus desktop, okay? Because here you have the Ubuntu, you have the blah, 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 you have everything. So you don't need to make it dirty. So this is the one. What is next? Let's install group. So go to store. No. Store. GNU. GNU. Store. 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 priority group. So we have to install from the repo. There is no, not is not available in the Ubuntu package. So we go to the Chrome group customizer Ubuntu, press enter, go here, and where is the code? These are the codes, so we add it to the repo. Paste the code here. No, it's not wrong. This is wrong. Paste the code. Your password, enter. And here, update. Updating. Wire mentioned Blaschbach. And you copy, let me copy, in German copy, I don't know what they call it, and paste in, and yeah, again, and yeah, and arbeiten is working, it means arbeiten in German is mean working, okay? So now, group, this is the group, your password. And here's all your operating system in the boot, Ubuntu, Windows, Debian, advanced for Debian, advanced for Ubuntu, and here the BIOS. Here the general. We modify this to make it previous. Here uncheck. We don't want time. So we want here. This make it black, this black, this transparency, light gray, here, no, make it dark gray, okay? And the background, make the black background, so I have, I install photo of black background, so I go to my file system, to my home, hider, picture, and this picture is the black. So this is my background. This when I go to the boot, I see, I will see this, okay? Now I want to maximize, resize the font. So the right font is Noto Mono Noto Mono Sans regular. Right, Ubuntu. So Ubuntu Sun Ubuntu regular. So type Ubuntu regular. Resize this window. And choose Ubuntu Mono Regular. This font. Other font does not work. Only this font is working. Okay? And you make it the size Triton is mean 30. Okay? Select. Press OK. Don't read this. Harmful. No, it's not harmful. It's very good. It's harmful for the company, but it's good for the user. So this is good. Now we have the font, bigger font. You update. To update, you press Control S. So you update the boot menu. So in the boot menu, whenever you boot, you will see this black screen in the front of your face. It's spam in your face. Don't harm your eyes. And you see here Ubuntu. So you go to Ubuntu. Here you can boot to Windows. Here you can boot to Debian. Here you can boot to the BIOS, to hack your BIOS, to change your BIOS. Now, Control Q, close this. Now we finish completely from the boot and how to optimize the boot. Let's see what's next. Okay, this we close, we optimize this boot. Now let's install Flatpak as a package manager. So let's see what we have installed to store, and let's see our operation. Yes, we have these are good, this is good, this is also good, not bad, it is good, the OBS, and the rest is very good. Okay, so we close this window, we go right Flatpak Ubuntu 18.04. So here, let's see how it works. Flatpak, and plugin. Okay, so here you copy these commands. Let's copy them. Control C, Alt T, Control V, Enter, password, Enter again. Highlight this, Control C, Control V, Enter. Enter again, highlight, Control C, Control V, Enter, highlight. So here he says there is four packages can be upgradable. So let's upgrade this package, sudo apt upgrade minus y. So now we upgrade all the packages. So control, so select now this command, let's continue. This command, select Control C, Control V, continue. Okay. Now let's make it in the login, in the plug. We plugged in the term. So what he says here? He says zero to remove zero. Okay, Control V. Yes. So let's add what he says. There is another thing to. So let's add the repository of Flatpak. Here, Control C, Control V, and we have to type our password, Kelly. Okay. Then we restart our system, and when we open the GNOME, the packages will be arrived in the GNOME store. So we open store, if we make the repo. Okay, let's restart this. Let's see if the Flatpak is arrived. Yes, this is the Flathub. Look, you install it, the Flatpak, you're getting your Flatpak metadata. So now we have the Flatpak is available in our repo, in our system. So we can get the latest and the greatest LibreOffice, latest and the greatest Eclipse, latest and the greatest Android Studio. So now let's check the system. Let's say sudo apt install htop new fetch synaptic. What's next? Just this. Press enter. Yes. So let's say I stop. Okay, so now we have a swap, and as I said before, I don't like the swap. I want to remove the swap, so let's remove the swap. To remove the swap, we go to our file to take the source code that I have, and this also, this is, let's customize this, show hidden file, and let's customize it. Preferences, allow folder, no, okay. So just show hidden file. So now type swap. Okay. So where is the swap? Here. Did you see memory? And here, swap, 0k of 2 GB of a swap. So there is a partition swap is not showing. So I want to kill this partition from the root. So open the terminal, copy this command. Sorry, this command. First write sudo apt-update date. My brain is faster than my fingers, therefore I forget letters. So now copy this command, go here to the terminal and watch this. It must be zero, so I will kill it. Look how I killed this one shoot. La la la. Okay, zero of zero. So it's I destroyed. Again, to be sure it will be killed, we edit the F stop. So sudo gedit. So now we log in as this. We pass this command. Password. Here. We add Noah time. Noah time. Regular. And here is the swap. We comment this. We use the hashtag. Hashtag Justin Bieber. Okay, and we comment this. So this is unsaved because there is a start. So to save it, Control S and the start disappear. Control Q, close it, and that's all. Another thing, let's edit the swappiness. So we copy this command. We paste it here. Press Enter. And go very, very down here, put the cursor here, press enter, too much enter, very, very enter, and copy this command, copy vm.swappiness, paste it here, and equal to 3. So this star is mean, it's not saved. So to save it, press Control S. Save it, Control Q, close it, and we are done here also. So the Noah time, the F stop, Noah time, we added before the error, and here the swappiness we added. So now we close this. Let's see. Okay, the system is great. The system look very, very great. There is no report error and there is nothing. So here we can check all the system. So from here, for example, I can close, exit the OSB or the OBS, what's the name of this? OBS, okay? So this, we remove it. So what's next? So here I can control my sounds. I can control my microphone. And this is my, okay, let's go to new, let's see, sudo, let's install aptitude, sudo apt install aptitude, press enter, and yes, and aptitude is instead of using sudo apt install, we can use, instead of using sudo apt install the package name that you want to install it, you can use sudo aptitude install the package name, the package you wanted. But to use the aptitude, you can use it as a normal user. You have to be super user. So first you go sudo I enter and you write aptitude install. For example, I want to install the new fetch and the screen fetch and press enter, and look how fast, yeah, and arbiten, and everything is arbiten, you see. Now type new fetch, and this is the new fetch, and the screen fetch, to screen fetch your fetch, okay? And this is the screen fetch. So here the screen fetch, and this the new fetch, and the kernel is 53046, and ThinkPad T470, and the long-term support Ubuntu, Bash 4.4, and the resolution 1920x1080, GNOME Shell, Aduita, icon and terminal, and i7 4 core, 3.9 gigahertz, and 31 gigabyte of RAM, and we use now 23 MB of RAM. So that is, but by the way, the icon is not occur because I use Parpios icon, not Aduita icon. So now we finish with this. Let's do another customization. The power management is very important in Linux. So you go to the browser, type TLP, press enter, and choose the TLP, and choose this guy, and go here to Ubuntu. You remember, we do this for Debian, we do this for Fedora, now we do this for Ubuntu. We highlight this, Control C copy, and open the terminal. And Control V, press enter, your password, enter, and update your system. Make the updating. Okay? Update your system. And install the following packages. Okay, install the following package, yeah. And this is Arbeiten, it means working in German, Arbeiten, or a function in Italiano. Okay, so now if you don't use ThinkPad, to this step is done. But if you are with ThinkPad, because you have two battery, the internal battery and the external battery. So you have to do this extra step. So let's read the manual. Read the manual. Where is ThinkPad? Okay. Packages. Okay, ThinkPad only. External kernel, ThinkPad, T40, okay, and later. External, optional external model, change resources, for older. For older ThinkPad, you use this TP, SmartP, DKMS. For later, T40, and later you use this. So we use this, the first one. ACPI call. Call DKMS. So here, instead of apt install, we use aptitude. So to use aptitude, you say sudo minus I, enter, then you type aptitude install. You highlight this, you copy it, Control C, copy it, and you paste it, Control V, paste it, press enter, and now it's installed. Look how it's fast. It's fast. Look, fast like crazy. And crazy like fast. Okay? So now you keep going. Okay. Now type TLP start. And TLP minus stat. Let's see if there's something missing. Okay, and everything is good. And since we hacked the BIOS, so now the first battery, the zero battery, the internal battery, it means the battery inside your machine, that's the battery inside the machine, start the charging from 80 and finish at 90. And the battery, the extended battery in your machine, start at 80 and the charge start at 80 and finish at 90, and this is very, very good. Okay, now let's check the temperature. TLP stat minus T, and this is the temperature, 53 degrees centigrade and 2895 the span, the fan speed, sorry, spanning, yes, spinning or spanning or Spanish or blah blah blah. So the speed of the fan, this, and the temperature is this. Let's see this, see the CPU. So TLP minus C, this is the CPU status. TLP minus G, the graphic status, and CLP, that's all. So let's go again. TLP start minus S, so makes save mode, and we close this, we finish this. Now we finish from here, from here, from here, from here, and we finish from here. Let's go to the store, let's install something from the flatback. Let's go to all, let's go to Windows. German, they cannot say W, they say V, Windows. Okay, from Windows, you type LibreOffice. Okay, LibreOffice, and you check the one with source, this one, DL Flathub, that means Flatpak. Okay, and you double check this Flatpak. Okay, you install it. Install it. Then Control F, Eclipse, developer mode. This is the developers. Okay, Control F, Evolution, and you check this Evolution, and you install the Evolution for your emails. And here you go to Blender if you want to. For me, I am now working the project, encoding, persist, after that, and the project to make the Godot to develop two-dimension gaming. Okay, it's open source project. So I need Blender. It's a Blender. I think Blender is German name, because it sounds like Bayer Mansion, Blaschbach, something like that. So let's type Blender, and we choose this one, not that one, this one, the newest. This is the Blender. Now we make it like this. Okay, let's see here. And these are applications that we download. And look, it's nicer. But to be honest, I am very critique against Debian. Debian is still neck to neck. No, I think Debian is better. Debian is better. It is. You see how long it take to deploy it. So now we have this, we finish this. Let's see what's next. We finish this. Let's start Kden, Kden Live, and we choose the Kden Live with the flat pack. Okay. Kden Live with the flat pack. GNOME calculator, because we don't have calculator. Or you can install the Flatpak calculator. I think, yes, there is a Flatpak calculator. Calculate. Calculator, yes, this. Flatpak calculator. It's more nicer. And system monitor, if you want system monitor, but I don't use it. So Kden Live, let's see, Kden Live, you install it. Yeah, it is installed here. This is the Kdenlive Live. This is the Blender. This is Eclipse. Eclipse, where is Eclipse? Or at Eclipse? Eclipse is not installed. No, it's installed here. So Sublime, install Sublime. So to those of you who are like me, Windowsian, let's install VS Code. Okay, this is the Windowsian religion. No, why? Keep doing it again and again until to reinstall. First time, third time, you know, it's like a tree. You shake it, you shake it, you shake it until it take the scenic. I just install. Okay, this is the Windowsian guys like me. Okay, so look now. Let me teach you something. So now you see the color, the human machine interaction between our human eyes to interact with these colors. Here is, it must be all dark. This is, I hate it. Why this is white? Why this is white? But we can solve this problem. We can. So yes, we can, as Obama says, yes, we can. We can solve this problem and we make all dark. So let's see if, let's type Sublime. Let's see Sublime. So let's install Sublime also. Let's see if Sublime faces the same problem. Yeah, the same problem in Sublime, the same problem in the VS Code. So we have, for example, here dark. So human machine interaction. This is the machine, this is our human, it does not interact well. When you say it's dark, then you have to make it all dark. There is no white. Everything has to be black to not damage your eyes. So because now you have dark theme. You know, in the top bar there is a dark. And suddenly there is a white and you are in the dark room, then immediately this ray, the white ray, will as somebody hit you in shoes in your eyes. Okay, so to solve this problem, just open the terminal. Guys, just open the terminals and write this command. Sudo flat pack update. Press enter and press yes. Look, these updates will solve this problem. This update will be solve this problem. So this will become black, dark. Look, the update is working. Okay, so the flat pack again update to see there is no update. So minus VV enter. Okay, so now close the terminal, close the Sublime, open the Sublime again, and the problem is solved. Look, everything is dark, dark, dark. Now close, sorry. Now close the VS Code. Now open VS Code. VS Code. Okay, open it from the store. Let's open it from the store. VS Code, because we have to restart the system to let the VS Code appear in our application. So, and that's the VS Code. Look, the white is done. We killed the white. We are anti-white. Okay. Now the white is dead. Okay. So now, are there some bullshit to change it? No, there is no bullshit. So let's close it. And let's maximize this. Let's close this guy also. Now let's install the PDF reader. Eviance. So Eviance. So we install this guy and this guy. Okay, you install this guy. So for example, I go to my study. I go to my file, study. And this mobile system engineering, for example, mobile system engineering, no. Information security. So look, there is no identity. I don't know, there's no thumble. in this PDF. Okay, so let's go here. So we install the first one. To make the identity, install the second one, this guy also, document viewer. Okay, your password. So now, refresh this page. Okay, now look, the identity. Refresh again. Now, if you log in and log out, this all identity will come true. Okay, let's go out. Okay, look. Software reliability and testing, final exam. Testing, this is the bitch. Professor Beach. Okay, let's close this. So now we solve this problem. So now, guys, we arrive to the end. And here, how I install Linux, how I create the partitions for Linux, and how I make the dual boot in Ubuntu as example, and how I customize the Ubuntu GNOME vanilla, and I make it look like this. Okay, let's close this. Let's take a general look. So it's a very nice distribution. I have some critique about the snap. I don't like snap because the next release, I will be not allowed to install Chromium via the apt. For example, the next release, the 20, after 3 days, maybe I will arrive 7 days, the next release, when I install Chromium via apt manager, the Chromium will be installed as snapped. Even if I uninstall snap, always the Chromium will install as snap. What this mean? This mean is the first step. That means Ubuntu now. I says Ubuntu is good and I love it. Now the critic, now the negative, I says about the advantage, the disadvantage of Ubuntu. What does this mean? When the user use the command sudo apt install Chromium, press enter, press password, press enter, then he discover that the Chromium is not installed as apt package manager, but installed as snap. What does this mean? This mean it is it's tricky the user, it's for me. That means the Ubuntu developer, in this case, he think I am stupid as a user, and as I am garbage. They didn't respect me. They disrespect my freedom and liberty. From the beginning says there is no, if I type this command, sudo apt install Chromium, and I press enter, says wrong, error. This package is not maintained in our repository. But don't install it. And after that, when I make my research, I find that the Chromium is installed not as an apt package manager, but as a snap package manager. This number one. What does this mean? This means Ubuntu developer, in this case, they put them foot in the first step on the route and on the road. This road will be lead to the bullshit. Because today, they make it with a Chromium. They install Chromium as a snap. So you don't use apt. Second thing, they will do it for driver. So all the driver will be installed as a snap. Next thing, they will do it for the screen resolution driver. Next thing, LibreOffice, it will be snap. Next thing, Java Eclipse, it will be snap. Next thing, Android will be snap, Blender will be snap, Cadian Life will be snap, USB drive will be snap, the shoes will be snap, and everything will be snap. So why you choose the snap package manager and you have the Debian apt package manager? So if you want to put your foot in the road that lead to the bullshit, so from the beginning, declare the dependency, the independent day, like the American, and says we don't follow the king, and we have our package manager, and we are independent distribution. Okay. This is the only issue with the Ubuntu, because they have also the bad habit. Ubuntu, they have some bad habits. The CEO of the, not Ubuntu, the CEO of the company, sometimes they have a bad habit. But let's be clear, they have the bad habit, but they have also the good habit. The good habit, they have good policy. They are good politician. For example, they solve the problem, the conflict between NVIDIA and the Linux. They are the first distro that make NVIDIA come to their knees and work perfectly. They are the first distro that make Ubuntu Linux a great distro. Because most of you, maybe you start with the Linux, with Ubuntu, the great community. Okay, guys, for this, in this video, I hope you learned something. And as always, stay safe, fight COVID-19, Andra Tutu Beni Ci Vediamo Dopo, ciao ragazzi.